Hi, Platform Health Viewer or PHView is my current pet project. I need an easy and lightweight way to collect and visualize the different key performance indicators of the web platform I'm responsible for. Stuff like CPU performance of important systems, user logins, HTTP requests and so on. So I started to play around with Ruby on Rails, jQuery, CouchDB and Node.js, and here's an early alpha I would like to demonstrate. My primary goal was to make the process from feeding data into the system to visualizing that data as simple as possible. In order to get data into the system, all you need to make is an HTTP call, which makes it very easy to collect data from very different sources. Let's try an example. I would like to visualize the CPU usage of my local machine. I'm going to collect this data using a standard Unix command, sar. That's an important aspect of my approach. It doesn't play any role for the platform health viewer where the data comes from. You're completely free to choose how to collect it. This way you can feed really anything into the system, from generic data like CPU load to highly individual stuff like the user logins of your specific website. Okay, here's how I can get my CPU user value on my OSX command line. Great, that will do. How do we push these values into the system? It's a simple HTTP post request using curl or CUL, like this. As you can see, the payload of the post requests is just three parameters. The source of the event, in this case MacBook. The name of the event, in this case I named it CPU user percentage. And its value, of course, which comes from the sar command. Again, you're completely free here. You don't need to configure event names and sources inside PHV. Just define them when pushing data into the system. It will happily accept it. We will see in a moment how to make sense of different events that were pushed into the system. Okay, let's use a small helper script I wrote in order to feed the CPU sys, idle, user, and nice values into my system. As you can see, this is all done using only standard Unix commands. Let's start the script. This is creating four calls to the system, four HTTP calls for the four different CPU values. For my helper script, I'm just providing two parameters here. The URL to my Platform Health Viewer installation, which resides on the same host for this demo, and the source name, which again I call MacBook. As you can see, my script pushes all four CPU usage values into the system. Now let's have a look at this data within Platform Health Viewer. Well, the dashboard is still empty because we did not yet define any visualizations. But the tag editor doesn't show any events too. This is because the events I pushed into the system have not yet been normalized to event types. This is an additional step because it will allow the system to push incoming events into the database as quickly as possible without the need to normalize those events regarding their name and source. This normalization is done using a rake task. Like this. This reads all created events from the incoming queue and normalizes it into another database structure, which is optimized for quick reading. Getting back to our tag editor, we can now see our four event types here. An event type is a combination of an event source and an event name. So MacBook, CPU, idle percentage is one event type. Let's see how we can use a tag editor to create something useful. Grouping one or more event types into a tag is what makes our data suitable for visualization. I'm going to name my tag MacBook CPU user. It will hold all events whose source matches MacBook, and whose name matches CPU user percentage. I could type those parameters into the text box, but it's easier to just drag and drop them there. So event source MacBook, and event type, event name is CPU user percentage. Okay, let's add this tag. Great, here we are. Now we have this first tag, and to check if it works as expected, I can preview the values of the matching events. So here we are. Let's push some new values into our system and check if they are visible here. We first collect the data and push it into the incoming queue. And we convert the queue to the final database. And now I have another value, recent created value for my CPU user percentage MacBook event type. I will now start the data push and normalization in a loop in order to get a lot of values. So I'm just going to put this in a watch and run it every 2 seconds. Okay, we still have no data visualization, so let's do this now. Let's switch to the dashboard and add a frame, which is a container that will hold our graph. A frame is a visualization of all values connected to a tag, so I need to provide the name of the tag I want to visualize with this frame. Here we go, MacBook CPU user. Add frame, and here we go. A simple line graph representing one of my CPU values. The graph is actually an SVG created using Raphael, an awesome JavaScript library. And thanks to jQuery, I can freely move and resize the graph. The graph's position and size is of course saved permanently. Let's create a graph with all my CPU values in it. Back to the tag editor. I'm going to drag all my values together. Let's name this one MacBook CPU all. And I need my MacBook event source and all four values. All for event name, sorry. Okay. I can also create tags by combining event sources and event names with already existing tags, as you can see here. So in order to get my CPU user event name into the math, I can just drag over my existing tag. Okay, add tag. Let's check the values of my new tag. And here we are, all four different values I've been collecting are visible. Back to the dashboard. I'm going to create another frame for my new tag. Here we are. Give it the same size. Okay, great. As you can see, this one contains four line graphs. I think one of the lines has a zero value and isn't really visible. Let's make it a bit bigger. It's still not enough. Okay, this looks better. Okay, I guess my, let's see if one of the values is zero. Yes, the nice percentage is always zero. This is why this line isn't visible here. Of course, the graphs definitely need a legend, something that's not yet implemented. Well, that's it. That's the current state of this project. I would love to hear your feedback. You can fork the code on GitHub or drop me an email. Thanks for your interest.